Hello everyone. Today I'm going to cover two different rotor dynamic beam models, which is an important concept to understand when you are running the rotor dynamic analysis. Most widely used beam models are the Euler beam model and the Timoshenko beam model. The Timoshenko beam model is a more advanced model that accounts for shear deformation and rotational bending effects. Accounting for shear deformation in your model tends to lower the stiffness of the rotor, which results in lower natural frequency of your rotor dynamic model. So it is important to understand which beam model is used in your rotor dynamic analysis and how these models affect your results. The Euler beam model is from simplification of linear theory of elasticity and ignores shear deformation. Here is an illustrative description of how the shear deformation makes the difference between the Euler beam model versus the Timoshenko beam model. The deformed shape of the beam from the Euler model is shown in the red line in the figure, while the deformed shape of the beam from Timoshenko model is shown in the blue line. As you could see from the deformed shape of the beam, the Timoshenko beam model is more flexible. Because it accounts for shear deformation, as you could see in the right bottom equation. So again, simply put, by accounting for shear deformation, the Timoshenko beam model tends to flex more, which drops the natural frequency of the beam or a rotor that you are modeling. So why is this important? This is important because what beam model you choose can lead to incorrect conclusion of your rotor dynamic model. I will give you an example. Let's say you have a machine that you are designing is running constantly at 4,400 RPM. And you are trying to have at least 20% of separation margin from the first and second critical speeds. Please note that 20% of separation margin is a typical target when you are designing the turbo machines. By using the Euler beam model, your analysis shows that first and second critical speeds are at 3,400 RPM and 5,500 RPM, respectively. This translates to separation margin of 22% and 25% respectively from the first and second critical speeds to your running speeds, which satisfies the targeted separation margin of 20% or larger. However, once you use the Timoshenko beam model, it is highly likely that your natural frequencies are smaller than those from the Euler model, as you could see in the figure. In this case, your targeted separation margin of 20% from your second critical speed to your running speed might not be met. Since the Timoshenko beam model reflects the reality more than the Euler beam model, it is recommended to use Timoshenko beam model over Euler model if you have a choice. In this particular case, when your separation margin is less than 20%, you need to find a way to stiffen the rotor to increase the natural frequency so that you have enough separation margin from the second critical speed. Having an enough separation margin improves the longevity of the machine by reducing the vibration. Today, I've covered the difference between the Euler beam model and Timoshenko beam model, and I hope you find this information useful. This is all I have for you today. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.